time that one you press.
I'm carrying on. I don't know if that recorded, but I found a Robinson grave a minute ago. That one there, I believe. Might not have recorded it on the video. It went, turned itself off then. That's a Scott. Christopher Scott. Of course, some of the family could have married somebody. Don't forget. James Scott. Another Christopher. Mary Scott, widow. I don't know what this building is here. James Shaw of Wensley, who departed this life 1837, age 43, and Ellen, their daughter, schoolmistress of Wensley, who departed 23rd of November 1841. She was only 21. There was a lot of deaths in the 40s. I think there was cholera outbreaks. Someone's tried to get in over there, look. It's just a small path. Well, we have found some. That's the moon. Thing. It looks like someone's done a bit of clearing up here. I mean, it's good that it's returned to wildlife, it's true. Thomas Merriweather. Oh, Thomas Merriweather. He died 1891, age 70, and Mary, his wife. Died March 27th, 1895, age 79. That's a merry weather. There's a way out there. What's this one? John Pearson Horn. Here, I wonder. Somebody probably squeezes through there, don't you think? There's loads more up here, look. But like I said, there weren't that many mentioned in the book, really. Something made me come here. And I've also believed my sister Jude would have been walking around here. They were big walkers and he liked the railway. We really need a fortnight up here to explore properly. I'm just doing a sample here. It's all you can do when the graveyard is left to be wild, which is good. I'm glad it is, but it makes it hard for us who are looking for the ancestors. People can walk around here easily. It's only because we've got rapid growth that we're actually having this trouble. But someone's been walking here for sure. Wensley. Wensley, who died December the 15th, 1776, aged 59. Also of Jane, his widow, who died December the 20th, 1809, aged 91. And this stone was laid in 1829, years later, by their grandson, John Buxton, son of their late son of Canterbury. Was his name Henry? Yeah, Henry Buxton. That's right. They all moved away. That's why I was able to link them so easily, because there's a link here from the family that moved away. So we're just going to have a little wander over here. Some in there as well, look. Yeah, we think you could come in the winter, right? And but it's freezing cold. I bet if I miss one, it'll be one of ours, will it? Yeah. If you miss one. See, there's some in there. Behind there, there's graves. They could have married going to, another family, you see, but they kept the name. By the way, I've just found. Like I say, in the winter, this will be easy. Walking through here, dead easy. And then we've got our Robson grave. It's Robson Ray. Robson Ray. And, I think that's mentioned. In affectionate remembrance of Thomas Bagley. And that could be Elizabeth, wife, 1879. So we've got Thomas, died 1879, could be that. Buxton's, Robinson's. Yeah, right towards the end, my friends. That's a tall stone as well, isn't it? As tall as me. You could be one of mine as well, Thomas. Yeah, you could be. I don't know when I'll be back, and I'm hoping I feel fitter tomorrow.